This is the next problem on resolution of forces. So in this problem, find the resultant of hook. This is the hook portion. The hook portion having three cables. So that is the T, F and P. So these three cables are connected at the hook. Just find or calculate the resultant of this hook portion. Okay, but how to find out the resultant? Already you know the formulas. Then R equal to under root of sigma H whole square plus sigma V whole square. Okay. So what is the meaning of sigma H? Sigma H means the summation of all horizontal forces. Okay. And sigma V means the summation of all vertical forces. Okay, so please see the procedure how to find out the sigma H and sigma V values. Okay, next. So first of all, draw the resultant forces. Resultant forces on a line like this. Okay, how many cables are connected? Three cables. First one is P equal to 150 newtons. Next, second one is P cable. So P equal to 150 newtons. Then third one is F cable 50 newtons. Okay. So this one is a max. That is, F force makes 30 degrees to the horizontal line, that is the X. Next, this one is a makes with horizontal is 40 degrees. Okay, so this one is having some 4 and 3. Okay, so in this case, the inclination of the angles are not given, so that you have to calculate the theta value. This is the theta. Okay, so how to calculate the theta value? We know that one procedure. Then tan theta equal to. So theta, tan theta means opposite by adjacent. Then 4/3. Then theta equal to tan inverse of 4/3. So what is the answer of tan inverse of 4/3? Tan inverse of 4/3. Equal to 53.13 degrees. This is the theta. So theta equal to how much? Then theta equal to 53.13. So opposite angles are same. So that, so please take this one is the 53.13. Okay. So, but how to find out the sigma H and sigma V? Sigma H means all horizontal forces, sum of all horizontal forces. So T and F and P, so these two are inclined forces. So let's just resolve into horizontal two components. One is the horizontal, another one is the vertical. So please see the procedure how to resolve the two components. So please take this force F or P. Now I am taking the force. The force is P. So resolve into two cases, two components. So just this force resolve into two components, horizontal and vertical. Next, again this force resolve into horizontal and vertical. And so this force also resolve into two components. One is the horizontal, another one is the vertical. Clear? Next. So please consider first force is P. Okay. So the angle of force P is 40. Okay. Now I am taking this is the 40 degrees. This one is the 40. Okay. The angle opposite is the sine. Theta means 40 degrees. So please consider force also. Force into angle. Next, adjacent is F, sorry, force is the P into force into cos theta. Okay, so for adjacent line, so please consider that is the cos theta. Okay, next, so take second one, means force F. The force F makes angle 30 degrees to the horizontal line. Next, angle opposite is the sine. So F into sine 30. Next, angle opposite is the angle adjacent is the F into cos 30 degrees. F into cos 30 degrees. This is the F inclined force. Next, consider T. Okay, so angle opposite is the sine. Okay, how much? T into, the force is T into sine 53.13. Angle adjacent is the cos, then T into this line, T into cos 53.13. So all the three forces resolved into two components. Okay, so after that, so take horizontal and vertical forces. Okay, see, next, now I am taking sigma h means sum of all horizontal forces. See here, so start with p force. Next, in this case, P cos theta is the horizontal force. This force is acting right side direction. So that's why I'm taking plus cos theta. So in horizontal direction, right side, the force is acting right side. That is plus, left side is minus. The force is acting upward direction plus, downward is minus. Please remember this concept. Okay, P cos theta is acting right side direction. Next, so please consider force F. The force F also acting right side direction. That's why I am taking plus. Okay, so this force equal to how much? Horizontal force equal to how much? F into cos 30. Force into cos angle. F into cos 30 degrees. So this theta equal to how much? First one is the 40 degrees completed. Next, so consider T horizontal force. Okay, so this is the first P horizontal force. Second one is the F horizontal force. Next, consider third force. The third force is T cos 53.15. See here, this force also acting right side direction. That's why I am taking positive. Next, sigma H equal to P equal to how much? 150 into cos 40 degrees plus F equal to 50. F equal to 50 into cos 30 degrees. Plus T equal to how much? Then T equal to 150 into cos 53.15. So all these three forces acting right side direction. That's why I'm taking positive. Okay. Next. So simplify this equation. 150 into cos 40 plus 50 into cos 30 plus 150 into cos 53.15. How much? The answer is 248.16. Okay, in terms of newtons, because of all our forces. Okay, next. Now I am considering sigma B. Sigma B means the sum of all vertical forces. So first consider force P. Okay, so this force is acting right side direction and upward. So that's why I'm taking. So this is the positive. Okay, P sine 40. So P equal how much? 150. 150 into sine 40. Now considering force F. This force also acting right side direction, right and upward direction. That's why I'm taking this one also positive. This one also positive. Okay. And how much? F sine 30. F equal to 50. Already given in this question. 50 into sine 30 degrees. Next. So please consider third force. This force acting right and downward direction. So downward direction is negative. So that's why. So please take minus T sine 53.13. T equal to 150. Minus 150 into sine 53.13. Okay. So simplify this equation. 150 into sine 40 plus 50 into sine 30 minus 150 into sine 53.15. Okay. 150 into sine 40 plus 50 into sine 30 minus 150 into sine 53.15. The answer is 1.38 newtons. This is the sigma V. Okay. So after that you need to calculate the R value. So then R equal to, what is the formula for R? R equal to under root of sigma H whole square plus sigma V whole square. Then the resultant force equal to sigma H, how much? 248.16 whole square plus sigma V equal to how much? 1.38 whole square. Okay. Then simplify this equation. So finally I got the answer is the root of 248.16 whole square plus 1.38 whole square then equal to 248.163 newtons. So this is the resultant of the hook portion. Okay, so this problem is very important. Okay, thank you. So please remember the right side direction in horizontal manner. Right side direction is plus, left side direction is minus, upward direction is plus, downward direction is negative. Clear?